grab the door.
That will be this thing.
I need all your information, you can send it out.
Oh, okay.
I need your address.
Oh, here.
Your phone information.
Okay.
Telephone number.
Where you can get reached at.
Yeah. And I need you to pull your address and telephone number. Okay, how's everything going with you getting your birth certificate?
Not well. I don't have ID. And I don't want to go through a service. I want it directly from the place where I was born.
Where were you born?
The District of Columbia. And they won't do it without ID, photo ID.
Yeah, but you can order it through the internet.
That's a third party agency. I want to get it directly from them.
Yeah, but why is that? Why can't you go through the
Because I don't trust them. I need it certified from the place that it originates, not from a third party certifying.
Okay. One of the other goals, you said that you want to start your own business. What's going on with that?
Going good. It's not in this county, but we'll see what happens when I have these conference calls, see if I can make something happen.
Okay, so now you are working for Willie. I did speak with Willie, so he did verify that you work part-time for him. Could you go ahead and mark part-time and put the amount that you get paid?
Don't.
I know sometimes he say you don't work, you don't get paid, but sometimes when you do pay, you pay at least $65 that day.
Okay.
So you put $65 at time.
Okay.
Okay, is everything else okay?
Sure. Sure, if I can get past this,
Involuntary servitude to save the Florida violation of secure rights of the U.S.
Mm-hmm.
We already went through this with the judge. He said that you have to do this because you, this is what you wanted to do.
Okay, and
your consequences, like you said, you may not like the option that you were given, but this is part of your deal that you did give up your rights when it came to going to your house. So I'm going to give you a time and date that I need you to stay home and be there for me, because I do have to go to your home.
Well, since you were there, and I asked him to provide an affidavit of his position, and he refused.
He said that he doesn't have it, like, in his office or anything, and that you can go ahead and contact Tallahassee.
Okay, I've done that, and that's in the works.
Okay.
So, but right now, I want to get this grievance in, and I'm going to request that you acknowledge it.
Okay.
Because I have to exhaust my administrative remedy before I take it to federal court.
Okay, yeah, no problem.
Civil matter.
I was waiting for this. I knew you were going to do this.
Of course.
I know you're going to do it because of the reason that I had to violate you. I knew it. Okay, what'd you put on me? Okay, no problem. What I do is give this to the main supervisor here. She's over this office, and then she'd probably give it to Circuit, and I would give this to them. Do you need me to make copies of this?
No, you can just sign.
Is one of them my copy?
Yes.
Okay, so I keep one of them, and then I give this also to my supervisor, okay?
Okay, and like I mentioned in that, the order is incomplete where it doesn't have a jurisdiction identification number. And that makes this incomplete.
Where is the jurisdiction identification number?
It should be right there.
Okay.
So I've been seeking jurisdiction the whole time,
mm-hmm.
and everyone wants to
ignore it. I can't ask to see what the local jurisdiction identification number is. I can ask my main supervisor, and then they can provide that for you.
Okay. As it states in the grievance, it's
mm-hmm.
Jurisdiction of the Department of Corrections
mm-hmm.
and jurisdiction of the court. I'm requesting that the Department of Corrections request a jurisdictional statement from the court, because if they wouldn't give it to me, like I've already stated,
mm-hmm.
I'm dealing with fraud.
Mm-hmm.
So if this agency is going to be a part of the fraud,
mm-hmm.
I need that collective information to proceed.
Again, I can just take that to my supervisor and
okay.
tell them that you're asking for the oath of the judge office.
I already have that coming.
Huh?
I already have that coming.
So now you need the oath of the officer.
Office. Your oath of office.
Okay.
And the jurisdictional statement of the court and the Department of Corrections.
The jurisdiction statement of the court, you're going to have to go back before the judge to ask for anything for the court.
Okay, so
I can just only let my supervisor know here. I'm going to have you write it down.
It's in the grievance.
Okay, so everything is in here.
Yeah.
So when they read it, it shows what you need.
And
okay.
I'm simply,
if it's in the grievance, then I have them, when they read over this, they can see what you are asking for.
Okay, and I'm specifically asking for the Department of Corrections to obtain a jurisdictional statement from the court. Plain and simple.
Okay.
What
I can do is give it to the person that runs this office, and then she can proceed the way she has to proceed it.
And I would
okay.
like all responses in writing for the public record.
Okay. I'll let her know that you want all responses in writing, because they probably go to her, but then it probably goes to Circuit or something like that, and they probably respond to you.
Well, they haven't responded to me thus far.
Well, who have you spoken to?
Everyone.
Like, who is everyone?
I've spoken to the clerk of the felony division, the clerk of the appeals division.
You're talking about the Department of Correction. You haven't spoken to everyone.
No, this is the first this is the first line.
Okay.
So once, once this office is defaulted.
Those are voluntary goals that you wanna work on.
Okay.
I said, yeah, Bank's gonna write me up.
No, I want you to understand.
I know you now. I know how you are.
Okay, I want you to understand something. And you may take it as a joke, but.
I don't take it as a joke. I look at the fact that you sincerely believe, what you're doing is, looking at the Constitution and taking it to the farthest of your ability to take it. And you believe that your options were not fair in which the judge gave you. I understand that.
See,
nothing that I can do about it, though.
No, it's your perception. It's your perception. Because you won't provide me the information or your position in an affidavit.
I don't have that information to provide.
No, the position you're taking, you simply put it in an affidavit and give that to me. That's all I'm requesting. Because everything that has been done to me has been done against my will of non-consent.
The only thing I do with the court is what I do is do what the judge tells me to do based on his orders. That's as far as I go.
And
when you don't do that, then in order for me not to get arrested and go to jail, I have to make sure I report that to the judge, just like I had to report the fact of what happened in that violation. I had to report that to the judge. I will be against what I'm supposed to do if I don't report those things to the judge. Now I'm going to give you, and the legislators tell us that we have to see people at their home and we have to verify. So I have to follow the legislator and I have to do this. So I'm going to give you a time to stay at home. I spoke to Mr. Willie. When I spoke to him, he said he's okay with you, that your time that you have with him is flexible. So I know that you can take off on December 28th. You don't have to take off the whole day. It's from 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. that I need to stay home.
I don't think I'm available that day.
You're going to have to make yourself available. Tell me the reason why you're not going to be available. Because you're going to have to make yourself available for me to see you.
Well, I'm working on a project of great significance.
Just have to tell me what that great significance is. It's not going to allow you to follow the...
Of creating work. Getting a job.
Okay, I need you to do that from 2:30 to 4:30. Take that work home or something.
I'm going to need, is there any way you can stop by this week?
Not this week, I won't be able to.
Okay, I can't guarantee that date. You said the 28th?
Mm-hmm, it's on a Friday from 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m.
I can't guarantee that date. Can you move it to January sometime, like the 7th?
I have to see you this month. I have to see you this month. There's no exceptions to that. They told me I cannot go without seeing you.
Who is they?
My superior.
And who is that?
My supervisor.
What's your supervisor?
You haven't been my supervisor.
What is her name?
Miss Pierre.
Miss Pierre?
Yeah. She said I can't go a month without seeing you. So I have to see you. Now, I am going out this weekend, but I really, I can't promise you on Friday because I have to be in the office all day long.
Well, I'm going to be available.
And then on the weekend, it's going to be a long wait. So if you're going to be available, make yourself available for 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. I'm going to put this down and hand it to you because you're not giving me a reason why you can't be available.
I have extensive meetings. So I'm going to request that it be put off till January.
I can't put it off until January.
Why not? It's just a simple request. I'm working with you. I'm just asking. I'm asking. You please don't get upset. Just, you know,
just a minute.
January.
Because I can't put it off until January. Let's see if my supervisor is here, but she has to be here. I don't know which supervisor is.
Let me I can ask him to come in and speak with me, but that's what I'm looking for.
Okay, well, let me see if the head supervisor's still here. What is... Now, I really think you're my person. I wouldn't be, if I thought you were really, you know, like...
A threat?
A threat or something like that. I wouldn't...
I'm no threat to any man, woman, or child.
All right. This is Officer Tidings. I have Mr. Bates in my office, and he needs to, he's requesting that I put off seeing him until the month of January. Yes, and she said I have to see him this month. So I told him that, but he wants to hear from one of my
I'm insisting.
He's assisting. He's assisting that one of you guys come here. She's not here. It's 5:00. You want me to walk him to your office? Okay, just one moment. Okay. She's in the middle of something really busy, and so she told me to put you on the speaker.
Hello?
Okay, Ms. Bryant, I have you here. Mr. Banks is here. He's requesting that we... I have not been able to go to his home, just to give you a backup story on it. He's stated that he did not give his right for me to come to his home. We already discussed this with the judge, and the judge told him that he does have to comply with our orders. So he said the thing is that he has a pressing meeting on the day that I need to meet with him, and he needs to see me this week if I'm to come over his place. My supervisor is going out with me, so I unable to do it this week, and I gave him Friday on December 28th from 2:30 to 4:30 for him to be home. He said he has pressing meetings all day. With his job, he works for Willie that he's reporting, and with Willie, I already spoke with Willie, and he said that he has a flexible schedule with him. But he said this is to do with his business, but he has not given me all the information concerning it.
Okay, and the problem is?
The problem is that he doesn't have time on that day to see me, so he is requesting that I do not see him this month since he doesn't have a time for the 28th, and that I extend to come to his house in the month of January. That will take another. He just started probation last month. He's in November or December. He started probation in, I believe, November. He started probation. He was placed on probation, and I still haven't been able to do the IT-30 that
needs
to be done.
It sounds as though sacrifices will have to be made, Mr. The offender.
Mr. Banks
will need to be available for supervision. If not, we'll have to notify the court. So, at this point, we have to make accommodations. So,
like I said, I'm willing to cooperate. I stated I'm willing to cooperate, but I'm humbly requesting put it off till January so it won't be any problems, I just need to take care of this, what I need to take care of. And after we get off the phone, I'll pull up a meeting so you can listen. I will as soon as we get off the phone. Will you be willing to sign a statement that I don't consent and I'm putting a value
of you consenting or not?
Yes, it does.
That's not the way probation works.
Okay, this is what I can do. I will, what I can do is December 28th or December 31st. That is the latest I can put it off. I cannot, and it has to be the morning of December 31st.
I'm asking for January.
Okay,
I'm going to have to report.
Can't work with that?
He said no, he's asking for January. So I already did all I can do.
Okay, out of those dates, you need to go ahead. You're given the opportunity to decide which will be better for you. So if I were you, I would just go ahead.
When you say better for me, I've already stated what was better for me. That's why.
We understand that January is better for you, but for us to fulfill our job and for me to, you know, fulfill what I have to do, I have to see you this month. I cannot put it off again. I tried to see you, but I wasn't able to see you when I did.
Are you willing to sign the sign that you're coming over and I don't know? Well, you can't. No.
Your officer is going to give you instructions as to, you know, when she'll be out to your house and when you need to be available. You've been given the opportunity out of the 3 days to decide what will be better for you. Now, if I were you, I would think about it and decide and go ahead and
January would be better.
Be there when you're instructed to.
Well,
if not, then the court will be notified.
Well, that's fine. And I must say that I'm not a slave. I'm a human being. And if you're going to treat me like that, then...
No one's trying to treat you anyway.
I beg to differ.
Other than being, we've been accommodating. We've been back and forth to court with you. I don't understand what else we can do, Mr. Banks.
Okay, the problem is... No, I'm looking for equal footing here, okay?
Right, okay. When
you
want to
insist that I'm an offender, no, I'm not an offender, okay? There,
so,
where there is no injured party, there is no case. I'm not anybody. I'm Eddie Banks. It has nothing to do with feelings. It has everything to do with facts, and no one has stood in the realm of facts. And I'm exercising my religious rights for that period. That's why I'm asking.
Oh, religious rights? So what? You just got to be saying with business.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Bryant.
Okay.
You know what?
Let me tell you something. You want to make a distinction, all right? You want to say you have to, you're compelled to do what?
Let me ask you something. What
can
day?
I finish?
No, because I got to go on to somebody else. I'm going to put you on my other date if you're going to come to the office. But this is the thing. What is going on at the 28th that is stopping you from me coming by your house? What's going on?
I have a meeting with some people, and I have a project that I really want to work on and get started on.
What people, what project?
What is your procedure for terminating probation here?
You go before you go before the judge. Judge got to terminate you. All right, this is what I have to do. Your next home appointment is going to be set for December 28th.
And I cannot make that.
You have not given me a reason why you cannot. You just keep saying a very general reason.
Because I
understand what you told me. Where's my little paper? Okay, your reason is, you said it's business.
I'm conducting business, and
conducting
that's a
business.
Religious period from the
20th. You're conducting business. Business and religion doesn't go hand in hand.
Listen to me, please.
I'm listening.
I'm conducting business, and from the 24th through the 1st is...
From the 24th through the what?
Through the 1st.
Through the 1st.
Of the year.
Of the year.
Mm-hmm. That is my time.
Okay, so you are conducting business from the 24th through the 1st of the year.
That's what I'm asking.
But you say you're conducting business, and then what else?
What do you mean?
You keep on saying you're conducting business from the 24th to the 1st.
Mm-hmm.
But you're not telling me what type of business.
communicating with other people of getting project and raising money to...
Okay, but that's still not enough reason for me not to tell you, to instruct you to stay home from 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m.
And I said, again, I'm not a slave, I'm a human being.
I understand that, but this is probation. And there's times
I can't,
that I have
I'm not going to be available for those periods.
And why are you not going to be available? Because you're conducting business with several people.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, this is what you're telling me. I am conducting business with several individuals.
Mm-hmm.
From the 24th to the 1st. Nothing to do with religion.
I don't feel I need to go into that because you already don't understand my...
You're going to have to go into it if you want me to... what you're telling me, you are not available the time that I'm requesting you to stay home.
You're not requesting, you're demanding.
Well, I'm instructing you. Yes, I am. I'm instructing you.
Okay, and
okay?
I'm asking you...
So I'm instructing you to stay home on December 28th from 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. You're telling me
I can't
stay home because you're conducting business with several individuals from the 24th to the 1st, but on your report, you have yours and my consignment at Willie Lakes. And I already spoke to Willie Lakes, and he told me that he's flexible with you. So it has nothing to do with your employment.
It's
it has something to do with a project you're working
it's
on.
It's a private
okay.
project.
Your next home appointment is December 28th.
And I will not be available.
You can, if you choose not to be there, then you have to deal with the consequences because I can't continue to go around you. Stay at home.
Okay.
I'm instructing you now to stay at home.
And I'm instructing you to provide me your oath of office and your lawful authority.
You can't instruct me to do that.
And if I can't instruct
you,
you
go to the court and have
and
the
you
judge
instruct me.
Stay at home. You don't have equal rights with me, okay? That's just the bottom line.
I don't? Why not?
You do not. Because you're on probation, I'm not.
I'm not
okay.
on probation.
Well, if you're not on probation, why did you report in today?
Because you're threatening to put me in jail.
I didn't threaten to put you in jail.
If I don't come, what are you going
to
do?
Threatened to put me in jail because I didn't report to your house.
Hmm?
Threatened to put me in jail because I didn't report to your house.
No, I'm asking, will you sign?
Okay, thank you. Okay, stay at
no,
home.
No, you're not listening to me. Are you going to sign the statement in regards to...
No, you. I already told you.
Then, okay, well, I'm sorry. I can't cooperate with you. If you're not
there you go. I need to stay home from 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. I instructed you to stay home. I accommodate you in so many different ways. And
how will you accommodate me when you're demanding something one-sided?
Because I gave you two different times, the 28th and 30th.
You can't give me anything if I can't give you anything.
You know what? It's time for you to go, Mr. Banks. Let me give you another time to come in. Do you want morning or afternoon this Thursday, Friday, 17th or 18th?
I don't want any.
I have to give you a date. Morning or afternoon, Mr. Banks.
You can put whatever you want. That's what you want. It's not what I want.
Or afternoon.
It's what you want.
Okay, I put down... Morning. I have to come in at 9:30 on Thursday, January the 17th. I suggest you go back to the court and let them know that you're not willing to do probation because probation knows you don't have equal ground with officers.
So you're telling me you have all of this alleged paperwork that's not complete, has no lawful standing. You've already stated that you're acting on behalf of the legislator. I have made a timely reservation of rights under the common law to which the legislative body does not prevail.
Here you go, Mr. Banks.
I don't want that.
You refuse to take it? You refuse to do probation, but here you go.
I'm not refusing to do probation.
Well, you're refusing to take what I'm telling you that you have to go. Here.
I don't want it. I'm sorry.
Wait just one moment. Just one moment. I'm going to hand him the date that you need to stay home as a deal witness. Okay, you need to stay home. Listen,
I heard you.
You cannot leave by yourself.
What do you mean?
I have to call you out.
Oh, okay.
Okay, you need to stay home. Begin to clean up. You need to stay home from 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. Is that understood? Is that understood? Here you go. You're refusing to take this. Okay.
You need to report back to the office January the 17th at 9:30. Is that understood? You want to take this? Can you witness that? Say you refuse. All right. All right, Mr. Blake. Take care. Thank you.